It's a hot summer day. You buy yourself a bottle of chilled water. After drinking it, you find the nearest garbage bin and dump it. But what next? What happens to the plastic bottle after you have discarded it? We are here to see the journey of a single plastic bottle with four different destinations, each of which is going to affect our environment drastically. Before we start, let's get to know this plastic bottle a bit, shall we? The word plastic originally meant pliable and easily shaped. It only recently became a name for a category of materials called polymers. The word polymer means of many parts. Polymers are made of long chains of molecules and are found abundantly in nature. Over the last century and a half, humans have mastered the technique of making synthetic polymers. Synthetic polymers are essentially long chains of atoms arranged in repeating units, often much longer than the ones found in nature. The strength, weight, and flexibility of these polymers depend upon the length of these chains. Now let's get back to our plastic bottle. It's waiting for us in the garbage bin. Destination 1. This is the most common one. The plastic bottle ends up in a landfill. When it rains, the water flows through the waste and absorbs the water-soluble compound of the plastic. This creates a very harmful stew called leachate, which is incredibly toxic. This leachate can easily move into the soil, groundwater, and even nearby streams, poisoning the ecosystem and wildlife. Let's move on to destination 2. Here, the bottle follows a journey. From the bin, it ends up in a stream that flows into a river, which ultimately ends up in an ocean. This scenario is equally unpleasant. After months of floating aimlessly in the sea, it is slowly drawn towards a massive trash vortex, where the trash accumulates to form a gyre. There are 5 such plastic-filled gyres in the world's seas: Indian Ocean Gyre, South Atlantic Gyre, North Atlantic Gyre, South Pacific Gyre, and the Great North Pacific Gyre. Here, the ocean currents trap millions of pieces of plastic debris, forming a cloudy plastic soup. Marine animals are directly affected by this. Seabirds often get tangled in the mess. Some animals even ingest the plastic, thinking it to be food. The plastic makes them feel full, even when they aren't, thus making them starve to death. These toxins from the plastic move up the food chain. How? A small fish eaten by a bigger fish is eventually consumed by us humans. So the plastic we dump finds a way back to us. How bad can destination 3 get? It is the worst. This is the process of incineration. Here the plastic bottle is burned along with other junk. Plastic, being a petroleum-based material, releases a lot of heat, pollutants, and toxic ash when burned. Like any other fossil fuel, the resultant global warming leads to rising sea levels, increased ocean and air toxicity, and destruction of coral reefs and other marine life. It has been proven that burning plastics is notably the worst possible end-of-life management approach for plastics from a climate perspective. Time for the final destination. Unlike the first 3 destinations, here the plastic bottle is not left at the mercy of nature or time. Instead, it is given a second life by the process of recycling. The bottle is taken to a recycling plant where it is compressed into a block along with other plastic bottles. The block is then shredded into thin pieces, which are then washed and melted to their original form. It is now absolutely ready to be molded into a new shape for a new purpose. In a report by WWF, it was confirmed that plastic isn't inherently bad. Unfortunately, the way governments and industries have managed plastic and the way society has treated it like a disposable, single-use convenience has transformed this life-changing innovation into a deadly environmental hazard. Wondering what you can do? Simple. Look for the recyclable sign on your plastic bottle. In case you don't find it, try and find a creative way to reuse it, like a planter or a bird feeder. Talk to your local authorities about the recycling process adopted by them. Sort the plastic waste from the rest of your garbage. This way you will be making it easier for the person who will be segregating. So, which destination do you want your plastic bottle to reach? The decision is yours to make. See you next time on another episode of Know It All. Till then, keep playing the quiz on Mind Wars.